Good morning, guys. 6:30 in the morning, super early call time, day of Chanel. We are gonna go have breakfast. How do I feel when I wake up? Oh my god, like going back to sleep, especially when it's this early. Tips to handle Fashion Week. Being able to go back to your hotel and like be alone kind of is kind of nice sometimes, just because you're around so many people the entire time and everyone's touching you and doing your hair and whatever. So I guess finding a moment just like for yourself to like chill out and like relax and take a breath. During Fashion Week, I think my style is like very fun. I like to be able to dress it up a little bit. During New York, I shot pretty much the whole week. I did 4 shows during New York. I didn't do Milan in London because I was shooting. And then I got to come in Paris. And I've only done 2 shows, and then this is gonna be my 3rd, Chanel. I wanted to get into modeling when I was like 13, 14. So I went to an agency in LA and they signed me. When I was 17, I went to New York with my mom and my manager. And we got recommended the agency that I'm at by a really amazing photographer. And they signed me, and ever since then, it's been like really good. My first show was Marc Jacobs. My first real show. It felt amazing to step out on the catwalk for the first time. It felt really awesome because we did it very secretively. No one knew I was doing Fashion Week. No one knew I was doing anything. Marc finally like accepted me, like wanted me to do it, and which I'm so grateful for, because I don't think I'd be where I am if Marc didn't like accept me how he did. So I did the show, and the show was very like, I had a wig on and bleached eyebrows, and you couldn't even tell it looked like me. Like, I looked kind of like an alien, and I was naked. It was the moment where I could say, okay, I'm really doing this. I think I have an awesome relationship with designers. I'm lucky enough to have a family who's also involved in the same kind of industry as me, so they're also friends with them. So it kind of keeps it very family related, and like Ricardo Tisci and Olivier Rousting, like we're all very, very close. I guess living your life like a model is basically living on an airplane. My mom is like always willing to like travel with me everywhere and like drop everything for me and whatever, because I think I'm one of her kids that travels the most out of all of them. Kim used to travel a lot, but she's settled down ever since she got married and had kids and whatever. And I get a little homesick every once in a while, so she's always like, I'll fly there now. So she's great. She's just such a mom, and she cares and she loves us, and she loves watching her kids like be successful and do the thing that they love. So I'm very excited for Chanel. I've heard a lot about this show, a lot of really awesome things, and I'm super excited. Carl never fails to like impress and one-up himself. So I'm super excited. It's gonna be a really awesome show. I remember my first season like going to their casting and going to all of that and thinking, I'm not getting Chanel. I'm like, this is impossible. Like, it's my first season. No one's really fully accepted me yet. Like, no, like, it's just, I'm still fresh. I'm still the baby. So I was really nervous, because it's one of, every time someone would ask me, what's your goal? I'd say Chanel, like walking for Chanel. So to be able to like have the relationship I've had with them and walk for them every season since, do the couture shows, be the bride, like it's like absolutely like mind-blowing. I can't even believe it's actually happening.